you notice that all of these Hamas encampments on universities all kind of look the same? Talking the same tents, same signage. I was at one of these protests recently and they didn't even remember the words to their little rhyme. So they were just reading off their phone. And I'm just gonna say it, the same looking people, you can always tell an activist from a regular person. The reason that all of these events look the same, they are being funded by the USCPR, the US Campaign for Palestinian Rights. Who knew? And it's funded by everyone's favorite guy, George Soros. His organization actually pays what they call fellows who start protests on campus. They gotta love capitalism, am I right? They like the socialism thing. They don't wanna get, money's bad, America, the worst, but here we are, capitalism. This organization pays up to $7,800 to community-based fellows. And then for campus-based fellows, they get somewhere between $2,880 to $3,660, very specific. Who wouldn't wanna sign up for that type of money in Joe Biden's economy? That's probably why these crowds are so massive. They mobilize so fast. Have all these tent cities across the country as it is. And then you have these universities embedded in these cities. And then you get paid if you just like show up and chant a little bit. You don't even have to memorize the rhyme. The math adds up here. And sometimes I see that they have like snacks and water to give out for free. I'd rather be poor with morals, but I can't speak for everyone else. But I do think I'm going to start calling what we're seeing here with these protests and riots as the tent city politics, population Democrats.
Democrats tell us money is the root of all evil in politics, and for once, they might actually be right. So is it money that motivates politicians? And if so, what's behind that money, and who is the person that pays for it? For liberals, that man is George Soros, and these are leaked memos from the desk of the billionaire progressive. They tell us what's behind that money, and let me just say, it should scare us. Soros gave $650,000, that's almost $1 million, to the Black Lives Matter movement to fuel the unrest that followed the death of Freddie Gray. He did this to, and I quote here, he did this to accelerate the dismantling of structural inequality generated and maintained by local law enforcement. Sounds insane, does it not? And his staff lied about it too. They denied ever sending money to the protesters, even though they did.
Let's talk about some of the protests overnight, because we have to turn our attention to this ugliness.
More protests, four nights
in a row now that these protests have been happening. And, you know, they've been smashing storefronts, smashing cars. Just take a look at the map right now, because this is where, we saw it in Portland, we saw it in some different cities, but look at this. It's now even spread to Florida, upwards Boston, up into Detroit.
Here's the thing about these. Usually protests spread when their legitimacy is growing, right? If you think about that, like legitimacy and the case is being building and things are getting bigger, this is spreading because it's intentionally being spread. More news is coming out about the funding from outside organizations, left-wing organizations, international organizations of elites that want to just say Donald Trump's not legitimate. Apparently the vote didn't matter.
And leaders behind these protests, including we now learn George Soros, Reverend Al Sharpton, George Soros, Reverend Al Sharpton, George Soros, Reverend Al Sharpton, Michael Moore, who's shown up to these protests. And so, getting out this message via social media, emails out to individuals. As Donald Trump had criticized these protests in the days after the election, they are not spontaneous. They're organized.
Right, but George Soros' piece is denying exactly what you're saying. He's saying this is not coming from outside funding. How dare you say that?
Shocking. George Soros, of course, will deny it. Having worked and seen organizations like this work for over a decade, they hide their funding. They never admit it. The group behind these protests and the ones that may happen at the inauguration, it's a group called ANSWER, International ANSWER, founded to oppose America.
Well, in case you haven't heard of this guy, you might want to find out, because this man, George Soros, is quite possibly the most evil person in the world, because quite frankly, he is trying to destroy the world. This is the guy who wants globalism to be a reality. Open borders, no nations, just one big shitty world. They give out this money to push an agenda. It's all about pushing the progressive agenda. That's what Soros is. He's a progressive. And we all know what progressive is, don't we? It's all the social justice, politically correct bullshit. It is the regressiveness that is sweeping across the Western world. Don't be fooled. Everything about the progressive agenda is evil with a smiley face on it. I mean, he's not the only one. There's plenty of rich assholes pushing this agenda, but they don't call him the puppet master for nothing. So, you know what I mean? It was in 2010. And take note of that date, because it's pretty important.
You handle the top down, but it's also bottom up. And inside out. Top down, bottom up, and inside out. So now your challenge as you leave here, our challenge, is to take care of that bottom up part and that inside out part, the heart part.
The heart part. That's what did it for me. He said the heart part. I'm like, that's not, there's something wrong here. But I didn't know what this meant. This is a tried and true technique that communists use to crush people of a nation between the members of a government at the top. Remember, he said, you've taken care of the top part. What does that mean? You put the right radicals in power. You've taken care of the top part. Then they get the radicals at the bottom to cause chaos. If you don't believe me, that's fine. I tell you, don't take my word for anything. You go ahead and look it up yourself. Let me take you back to where I took you at the beginning of this program, Czechoslovakia. I only told you half the story of what the Czechoslovakians thought was happening to their country in the late 1940s. After World War II, Czechoslovakia was in real trouble and people were hungry and there was strife. And a small group of communists managed to gain power in the Czech government through parliamentary maneuvers. That was taking care of the top-down pressure. Meanwhile, unbeknownst to all the people in Czechoslovakia, they were agitating people, getting them out into the streets, riot, strike, protest, create the illusion of a widespread clamor for change. That was the bottom-up pressure on the system. Well, the people were left in between, and they didn't know the truth. They didn't know what was going on. They were hungry, they were scared, they were confused, and they were looking for help. When they cried out for help from the government, which they thought was not with the rioters, oh, they got help. They had no idea that some in the top were in league with those creating the chaos at the bottom. The people at the top had formed a shadow government, and they were only too happy to help, and they helped by clamping down on the Czech people. So the Czech people were hit from both directions, top down, bottom up, and inside out. Their country was turned inside out. They didn't know what to believe. The same is now being called for.
Is it all starting to sound a little familiar? Remember, this was in 2010, and he was saying this. He was saying that this kind of shit was going to happen. Be on the lookout, America. So let me play that again and see if it makes a little more sense this time. Install a federalized police force.